This PhysCast will look at normalising a wave function that is a superposition of energy eigenstates, in this case of a harmonic oscillator. Pause the video and read through the question carefully. Now that you've read through the question, you should see that you've been given a superposition state, that is a linear combination here of energy eigenstates of a harmonic oscillator, and you're being asked to calculate a particular value, capital A here, that will normalize that superposition state. So we can think about a superposition state that we have here. We can think of simply being some linear combination with appropriate coefficients of some energy eigenstate. So we could say C0 as a multiple of the n equals 0 eigenstate plus C1 times the n equals 1 plus, and on we could go with as many of these as we might have, maybe including, you know, the nth one out here. And this is possible for any set of energy eigenstates for any particular system. We're dealing here with harmonic oscillator states. Now what's important here is we can recognize that in our particular superposition state, we only actually have three contributions here. We should be able to see that all of these coefficients are zero except for the multiple of psi 2 here. So we can see that C2 from our given expression here is equal to 1/2. We should be able to see that C3 here is actually this quantity A that we're trying to determine. And the only other non-zero one here is C5 here is actually negative 1/2. And all the other coefficients in this particular superposition state are zero. So it should be fairly easy to handle. Only these three contributions to our superposition state. Now, importantly, when we're going to find a normalization here, what we're saying is we really want the integral over all space of the modulus squared of our wave function, in this case, this superposition state here. We're going to integrate that over all space. We want that to equal 1. That's the normalization condition. And importantly, if we're dealing with normalized energy eigenstates, and that's what our question tells us. It tells us we're dealing with normalized eigenfunctions here for our harmonic oscillator. Then when we go through and do all the products of these cross terms, when I do psi star times psi in this mod squared of my wave function, then I find a couple of things happen, and you should refer back to your textbook or lecture notes to see that what's going to happen is those integrals will either give me 1, because they're normalized. So if I do psi 0 times psi 0 integrate that, I would get 1. Or they'll give me 0, because my energy eigenfunction actually orthogonal functions. That is, when I integrate them, like the product, say, of psi 1 star psi 3, I get 0. And the upshot of all of that is I can write this integral here simply as the mod squared of all of these coefficients. And again, you should make sure you understand why that's the case, provided, of course, that I'm dealing only with normalized energy eigenfunctions. So in our case, that becomes quite straightforward. Remember, most of these are zero in our superposition state that we've been given in our problem. So I'm really only going to end up here with the mod squared of C2. It's going to be 1/2 squared. That'll give me 1/4. The mod squared of C3, well, that'll give me capital A squared there, where for the time being, I might as well consider capital A to be real. And then I'm going to add the mod squared of C5, which will be minus 1/2 squared, which also gives me 1/4. So I can see that's going to give me there A squared plus 1/2, because my 1/4 plus 1/4 gives me 1/2. And remember, what I really want for normalization is that to equal 1. So you should see there that A squared must equal 1/2. Or I can get my final result here, that A here should actually be plus or minus. There's two possibilities here of 1 on root 2. So if I replace the capital A in my superposition state with either plus or minus 1 over root 2, I would have a normalized wave function there. It's worth spending just a second now to see if that makes sense given our understanding of what these coefficients can also tell us. Remember, these coefficients squared will tell us the probability of being in a particular energy state, the probability of being in some n eigenstate here. Turns out to simply be the mod squared of that coefficient in my superposition state. So this should tell us in our particular case the probability of being in the n equals 2 state will just be the square of that coefficient. That will be 1/4, or 25%. The probability of being in the n equals 3 state will be capital A squared, but we just determined what capital A squared was. It's going to be 1/2. And the probability of being in the n equals 5 state will again be the square of its coefficient. That will be minus a half squared. That will be a quarter. The probability of being in any other state will be zero. So if I was to determine, the energy state, the energy that this harmonic oscillator had, if I measured its energy, there's only three possible values I could get. I actually can't say what the energy of the superposition state is. It doesn't have a well-defined energy. It's not a state of a given energy. But if I was to measure the energy of the oscillator in this state, there's only three possible answers I could get with these probabilities. 25% that was in the n equals 2 state, 50% was in the n equals 3 state, and 25% was in the n equals 5 state. And of course, importantly, they all add up to 1. That is, it's 100% likely that I'll find it in one of these three states. So it seems that my normalization here does make sense in terms of my understanding of what the square of those coefficients in my superposition state actually tell me.